ownership, Andrew Friedman, Dave Roberts.
This is Julio Urias, and he just had the appearance of his life. Three outs left until World Series champions,
Lucas.
And he got all of them out. He achieved the goal that every MLB player puts their heart and soul into to try and get. But Julio has been through a lot, and his story is pretty inspirational when you think about it. How is everybody doing today? It's Sports Huddle back with another video. Today I'm going to talk about Julio Urias and his story to the MLB. Let's not waste any time, and let's get straight into it. Now, I have made a lot, and I mean a lot of videos on this channel where I talk about players and how they got to where they are. This one is pretty much the same thing. Julio Urias played on a Mexican baseball team as an early teen, and one day, Julio met a man named Mike Brito, who scouted players and actually scouted Fernando Valenzuela. In 2012, at a showcase game, the Dodgers took their first look at Julio Urias when he was just 15 years old. Ironically, on his birthday, which was August 12th, the Dodgers decided to give him a shot and signed him for $450,000. So now that you know a part of how he went to professional baseball, let me tell you something that occurred during his childhood that wasn't the best. Now I have a question for you guys. Have you ever noticed and wondered why Julio's left eye is more closed than his right eye? Well, there's a whole story on what actually happened. Julio underwent three surgeries on his left eye. The reason that it cured was because he was trying to remove a bending mass. Then in 2015, he underwent another surgery for his eye. When asked about this, he said, quote, "That's how God works. He gave me a bad left eye, but a good left arm." Speaking of that left arm was capable of throwing 98 miles per hour. Let's take a look at how his minor league career went. Now, his minor league career was really good. He made the minor league All-Star game in 2014, and in 2015, he was ranked first as a left-handed pitching prospect. And in 2016, at the age of 19 years old, Julio Urias made his major league debut. He was the youngest pitcher to start in an MLB game since Felix Hernandez in 2005. And when it comes to the Dodgers, well, he was the youngest pitcher to start for the Dodgers since Rex Barnett in 1943. In his rookie year, he went 5-2 with a 3.39 ERA and had 84 strikeouts. For a rookie who's 19 years old and who had four surgeries on the same eye, that's a pretty good season in my opinion.
I love you,
Bobby. But wait, it gets better. That same year in 2016, Julio Urias became the youngest pitcher to ever pitch in the playoffs for the Dodgers. So 2016 was a big year for Urias. And in 2017, Urias was optioned a lot, where he was called up and called down a lot. He only started in five games at a 4.5. He had a 5.40 ERA. But something worse happened where he had a left shoulder injury and he had to have surgery. And in 2018, he was still recovering from that surgery, so he didn't play that much. He had three appearances as a relief pitcher. However, he was still on the Dodgers postseason roster. In 2019, Urias started off as a starter due to Clayton Kershaw's injury. He would end up returning to the bullpen when Kershaw returned from his injury. And then after another problem occurred that same year. In May of 2019, Urias was arrested for domestic battery. He would end up returning to the team on May 31st, but would end up getting suspended for 20 games in August. He did pretty well in 2019 as he went 4-3 with a 2.49 ERA and had 85 strikeouts. Overall, not a bad year for Urias. And then we come to 2020, which not only was a big year for him due to the pandemic, but also when it comes to baseball, it was the biggest year of his life. Let me first remind you, this was Urias' fifth year in the majors and he was only 23. I guess that's what happens when you have your major league debut at 19 years old. Urias pitched pretty well in 11 appearances as he went 3-0 with a 3.27 ERA and had 45 strikeouts. Not a bad season at all. But then we come to the biggest part of his life, the postseason. At first, this was pretty much just another year in the postseason for him, but this year was different. Urias was both a relief pitcher and a starting pitcher in this postseason. He started 2 games in the postseason and had 4 appearances from the bullpen. And his 4th one was one of the biggest ones of his life. It's the bottom of the 9th. He just needs to get 3 outs. That's it. 3 outs, and then he's world champs. Starts off with getting a flyout to right field against Manuel Margot. Next is Mike Brosseau, who he ends up striking out. And it all comes down to Willy Adames. Starts off with a swing and a miss. Strike one. Then the next pitch is called a strike. Urias is 1 strike away from getting his first ring and getting a lot of his teammates their first ring. And the next pitch is history.
Ownership. Andrew Friedman. Dave Roberts. And strike 3! Dodgers have won it all in 2020!